Once all my people, the ones dear to me, speak to the heart of Jerusalem. The time of your mourning is ended now. The Lord of life will come. A voice cries out in the wilderness, prepare a way for the Lord. A voice cries out in the wilderness, make straight a highway for God.
Welcome to Cathedral. I'm Father Greg Sackowitz. Special thanks once again to Mark Teresi and David Jonas, not during only the season of Advent, but year-round. Mark and David, thank you for the beautiful, beautiful music you do together. Special thank you today to Lori Doyle. Paula Kleen is under the weather right now, so Lori Doyle has stepped in, who does all the electronic bulletins, the hard copy bulletin, but now she is going to be the producer of today's and next week's spiritual video. So Lori Doyle, thank you very much for all you do. Folks, we've now started the second Sunday of Advent, and Christmas is 2 weeks away. So I will begin this way. Summer vacation was over, and all the first graders were back in school, back in September. And teacher says to the first graders, boys and girls, where'd you spend your summer vacation? And little Johnny says, we spent it in Saskatchewan. And teacher says, Johnny, that's a beautiful word, spell Saskatchewan. He said, second thought, we went to Green Bay. But guess what? I still don't like the Green Bay Packers, even though Lori is a diehard Philadelphia Eagles fan. I'm a Bears fan. The Eagles are a better team, but I still don't like the Packers. In a Maryland Missionary magazine some years ago, I'd like to share this short missioner's story written by Sister Kerrigan. Mr. Chen was a patient in the hospital where I work in Taichung, Taiwan. He had AIDS. He confided in me that he was afraid to die because he had never practiced any formal religion. But I have a God in me, he said, pointing to his heart. And I replied, tell me about your God, and I'll tell you about my God. I can't share my God with you, Mr. Chen protested, because you are a well person, and my God is for me, people like me, with AIDS. When I assured him I would understand, Mr. Chen began, my God is very forgiving and doesn't keep thinking about the bad things I've done my past life. My God wants to help me not be afraid. My God is beautiful, and the best thing is my God loves me. Mr. Chen, I said, if our gods aren't the same God, they're identical twins. We listen in today's second letter of Peter, the second Sunday of Advent. The Lord shows us generous patience, since he wants none of us to perish, but all come to repentance. And again, in today's gospel passage from Mark, make ready the way of the Lord, clear him a straight path. We are called to repent and start over. Our God is a God of second chances. God forgives us faster than we forgive ourselves. But to change our heart means a new way of acting, which leads to new consequences. The following story connects my point. Some years ago, when I was pastor at St. Mary of the Woods in Edgebrook, I visited the children in the religious education program. In one of the classrooms, I think it was in third or fourth grade, I asked the children, if we repented and everyone started loving and acting more like Jesus, what are some of the changes we would see in our country? Little Brian, whose father worked at WGN-TV, raised his hand and said, if the whole world started becoming a better place, the 10 o'clock news would only be 15 minutes long. In his mind, only good news because the world will be better. For in his mind right now, all the news he sees is bad news. The TV news would be shorter if we all were nicer. Advent is a wonderful opportunity for us to return back to the basics. Advent invites us to ask ourselves, what is really important to me? And who is really important to me? Advent, and especially today's readings, challenge us to look at the priorities in life. Above all, Advent and our readings today ask us if Jesus is the number one priority in our lives. All three readings talk about the need to prepare the way for the coming of the Lord. All three readings tell us that if our lives are not what they should be, then we should do something about it. In other words, if we strayed from the basics, then today's readings invite us to return back to them. If we have placed our work ahead of our families, then today's readings invite us to change the situation. I've been a priest now, the grace of God, the gift of priesthood, 44 and a half years. And those 44 and a half years, I've spent many times at the bedside of someone dying. And in all those years, no one has ever said to me on their deathbed, you know, I wish I'd spent more time at work. No one. In over 44 years, I've had people on the deathbed said, if I had it over again, I'd spend more time with family, with loved ones, taking a walk in nature, taking time for myself, but especially family. But no one in all those years ever said, you know, Father Greg, I wish I'd spent more time at work. If we have placed success ahead of personal relationship with God, then today's readings invite us to change this. Where do I put my energy? What are my priorities? Where our treasure is, there will our heart also be. Where our treasure is, there will our heart also be. The following poem was written by an elderly man on his deathbed. I was a revolutionary when I was young, and all my prayer to God was, Lord, give me the courage to change the world. As I approached middle age and realized that half my life was now gone without my changing a single soul, I changed my prayer to, Lord, give me the grace to change all those who come in contact with me, just my family and friends, and I shall be satisfied. Now that I'm an old man dying and my days are numbered, my one prayer is, Lord, give me the grace to change myself. Lord, give me the grace to change myself. If I had prayed for this right from the very start, I should not have wasted my life. This is what Advent is all about. It's a time to take inventory of our lives and make changes. One of the greatest tragedies in life is to believe God could never forgive me. God forgives us always. We have to be able to forgive ourselves. But the destination is not as critical as the journey. I've said this so many times. No matter how many steps we take away from God, it only takes one step to get back to God. Someone once said this, we are like animals when we kill. We are like human beings when we judge. We are like God when we forgive. We are like animals when we kill. We are like human beings when we judge. We are like God when we forgive. May God bless all of you. Continued Advent blessings leading to Christmas morn. Amen.
You shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak your words to foreign lands, and all will understand. You shall see the face face of God and live. And I will.